How do we create a ramp that blends from this higher face into this lower face? One important aspect of the ramp is that it needs to follow the shape of these two arcs when looking from the top. We shall use this model as a starting block. I will leave a link below for you to download this if you wish to follow along. Let's start by creating a split line that defines the starting point of the ramp. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box. Instead of creating a sketch line as a split tool, we can actually make use of this face as a splitting tool. Check on the Extend Splitting Tool option. This will naturally extend this face to cut the face in question. The plan is to create a loft that goes from this edge to this edge. To guide the loft to follow these arcs, we need rails. Start a sketch on this face. Let's create the outer rail first. Let's draw a straight line to join these two points. You will need to have the Auto Project Edges on Reference option turned on for this line to be able to snap. This line represents how the rail will look like from the front. We need to convert this edge into a sketch entity. However, this edge is not on the current sketch plane. Instead of starting another sketch, we can use the Include 3D Geometry command. Go to Create, Project Include, Include 3D Geometry. You can think of this as a project command that works in 3D. We are free to project edges that lie outside of the current sketch plane. Once we select this edge, we can see the projected line in purple. These two lines represent how the rail needs to look like looking from the front plane and the top plane. We have to find a way to project them onto one another. The projected line cannot be in the same sketch, so let's finish the sketch. Since the resultant line will be a 3D sketch, we can start a sketch on any plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersection Curve. If you select the line, and then the arc and confirm, you might encounter this error. To avoid this, you can change the order of selection. Let's undo and repeat the command. Select the arc and then the straight line. You can see how the resultant line matches up with the two previous sketch entities when viewing from the front plane and the top plane. Let's hide the previous sketch entities. Label the new projected line as a first rail, and hide that also. Let's repeat these steps to create the second rail. Again, begin a sketch on this face. And join these two points with a straight line. use the include 3D geometry command to convert this edge. Finish the sketch. Begin a new sketch on any plane. Use the intersection curve command to produce the second rail. Label this sketch as the second rail. And bring back the first rail. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Loft. Loft from this edge to this edge. Click on the arrow for rails. And select the projected lines as rails. For both profiles, set the continuity option to tangent and align to surface so that the lofted surface will be tangent to the adjacent faces. If you see this error, this means that we need to change the tangency direction. In this case, we can see the profile 2 has a tangency pointing up. With profile 2 selected, scroll down to the tangency direction option and flip it. Next, we can use this existing face to perform a solid extrude up to the newly created lofted surface. Set extend type to 2 object. And select the lofted surface as the object. Set operation to join. From here, we can either hide or remove the lofted surface body. The second method is somewhat easier and also gives an insight into how the intersection curve command works. We will start from the point after this split line was created. Let's create a sketch on this face. As before, we will be drawing straight lines to represent how the rails look from the front plane. In this case, I will draw both lines on the same sketch. Let's first extrude this face up. The exact extrude distance does not matter. We just need to extend it beyond the higher face. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select the outer arc face to split. And select this line as a splitting tool. This actually gives a very good visual representation of what is happening under the hood of the intersection curve command. If we can imagine extruding the previous two sketch entities into surfaces, and then intersecting them with one another, the resultant line will be the line of intersection. The split line command here produces the same result. Let's bring back the sketch and repeat this for the other arc face. With these two split lines acting as rails, make a lofted surface as in the previous method. Let's change the opacity of the solid body so that we can see this better. We shall use this surface to split the body. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the main body to split, and select the surface body as a splitting tool. We can remove or hide the excess body on the top. If we go back to the point just after the split faces were created, we could also have deleted these faces and made a surface loft to patch up the opening. Do take note that this results in a hollow surface body. So you will need to stitch all the surface bodies into a solid.